Ma'am.
Favorite discussion, for good or bad. I'm going to start with you. Should Garrett have gone for it on that fourth down play?
You know what? As a lifelong Dallas Cowboy fan, I hit bottom last night with that decision. You know why I hit bottom? I couldn't work up a single ounce of mad about it. Usually, you know me, I would be out of my mind. On Twitter, I would be out of my mind with an all caps tweet about what is Jason Garrett thinking? Usually, Jason Garrett goes for a lot of things. He'll run fake punts. He shocks me with how he'll gamble sometimes, Coach Clapp. But in this case, I think he was seeing what I had seen, what the rest of America had been seeing for about 3 hours, right? 3.5 hours. The Dallas Cowboys, America's team, have the worst offense in America. They are inept on offense. Their play caller is inept. So I just sat back, lifeless, and thought, I can't blame him for punting here because I don't think they can get a yard and a half. And that's about what it was, a yard and a half. I don't think Scott Linehan can dial up a play that will make me say, wow, I hadn't thought of that. That tricked him. I don't think he could do anything but give it to Zeke again, right up the gut, and he would get stuffed after about a half yard because he had just lost a half yard on the previous third down play. So all I know is that I had just had to watch near the end of regulation my Cowboys create two big splash plays in that game. The first one was a escape bomb. I don't even know how he did it. Throwing across his body, Dak Prescott threw it to Tavon. Was it a pass and a prayer? It probably was. But Tavon caught it, and all of a sudden they're in business, first and 10 at the 31. And I think, here we go. And we went backwards. And we managed to get a 48-yard field goal out of it. But then Tavon comes to life again with a 22-yard punt return. And we're back in business, first and 10 at our 45-yard line. Let's get a field goal out of this. And we go backwards with some of the most inexplicable play calling I can ever remember. So, obviously, Houston took Zeke away because he was 20 carries for a grand total of 54 yards. He couldn't get loose on any sort of swing pass or really much downfield at all. So, he wasn't a factor in the passing game. They have nobody who can separate. So, Houston is sending 4, 5, 6, 7 people in run blitzes. That's what they were mounted to, just run blitzes, because the corners and safeties are saying, well, we can cover man because they don't have anybody can run by us. So in the end, I'm thinking, I got a top five defense that is playing its you-know-what off. It is playing its – and all of a sudden, Jalen Smith is turning into a star.
Sean Lee not getting that job, man.
The tackling Dutchman, is that what you call him?
Tackling
Van Der Esch?
Yep.
He can run a little bit. Yeah. He can hit a little bit. And I'm saying, Wouzier and, hey, Byron Jones, he played his tail off against DeAndre Hopkins, and it was a one-play game for Houston, and finally DeAndre got loose. I don't know how they got him man-to-man on Anthony Brown. He's their weakest corner. But he got loose and made the one play because they got a DeAndre, and we don't have a DeAndre. So would I, if I had been Coach Clapp at that point, would I have gone for it? I probably would have, but I would have called the play. I would have called a zone read with Dak pulling it back and taking off left tackle when those ends crash down to stop Zeke in the middle. And I would have called the play that would have gotten 5 yards, and we would have been back in business again.
Do not blame Jason Garrett. If you want to blame Jason Garrett for anything, blame him for that dumb challenge.
Oh, my God.
I don't think it was that dumb.
But God dropped the ball through the hill.
It's a new rule.
No, it's
a new rule.
Skip.
Did he not control the football?
No.
He controlled. Did he get 2 feet down?
Yes, he did.
But you can't hit the ground and the ball pops out.
I thought we were beyond
I agree with you on that, because I'm thinking, if you were the opposing team, you would be like, you wouldn't even dare challenge. Like, you would know.
What are you challenging?
That's my best play as a challenge. That's all I got.
But I'm not blaming him. I do agree with you. I think he just saw Zeke lose a yard and a half to a yard. He had more confidence. But I'm trying to figure out, for the life of me, we've been on air now, 6:30, so an hour and 19 minutes, and you have yet to blame Dak Prescott for anything. And I'm just
waiting here. Played pretty well under the circumstance.
For real,
time did he have to throw?
Whoa, you just said it, Deshaun Watson. How much time did he have to throw?
Hey, he had a lot. He had way too much time. There were half the time I would sit back there and say, when are they going to touch Deshaun?
I thought Deshaun Watson was at the doctor's office. Every time I see him on the sideline, they got a stethoscope to him. I was like, what's going on?
Well, I can't help it if he's brittle. I don't know.
He's brittle.
Where he took his punishment was trying to run for touchdowns.
He had more confidence in his defense than his offense. But that should tell you something, because I saw a guy up in Seattle, and Sean McVay watched Todd Gurley get stopped on a third and one, and he says, you know what I'm going to do? I have the utmost confidence
in my quarterback. They're playing with house money. They're on a roll. What do you expect from the Rams?
They got the
best offense in football. What do you expect they're going to do?
You got the best offensive line.
That's an easy call. I do not. No. They don't play like
that. You got the best offensive line in football.
Where's Travis Frederick on IR?
Whoa, you told me that when they didn't put Travis Frederick on IR,
they thought so too.
He's going to be back sooner than later.
Eight games, and now forget about that.
What did Stink tell you? Uh-huh. He went through that. Stink told you it took him like 18 months to come back.
He was correct, Mark Schlereth. He did.
Look, this is simple. Jason Garrett made the correct decision.
Mm. Correct!
He made the correct decision not to go for it. When you're in the midst of a game, as a coach, as a player, you know who's playing. If we're playing basketball and I know who had the hot hand, I'm going to go to that person.
Beat him!
Mm-hmm. But offensively, they did not have it going. Defensively, however, I can trust my defense right now because they've been reliable all game. Mm-hmm. They've been getting it done all game. But you talk about Dak Prescott, and I've been critical of Dak Prescott. I thought Dak played a good game. I thought he played well enough to where they could have won. His receivers let him down yesterday. Mm-hmm. His receivers let him down. His offensive line let him down. I saw him making plays that, I mean, what else can you ask for him to do?
To win.
But in that decision, in that moment, if I'm the head coach and I'm gauging my offense versus my defense, it's a no-brainer. Their defense was playing with all the momentum, lights out. Yes. They felt like we can stop these guys anytime. Mm. As a coach, you see that, and you go with what you believe
punt,
and what you feel.
Punt the ball, pin them down.
And it's a game of inches,
field
position.
The punt went to the 10-yard line. Right. Yes. That'll work, right?
Yes, and you if you have to lose, yes, a play that DeAndre Hopkins made, it doesn't happen.
Players
every
make
single,
plays.
Players make you.
Okay,
you're still
in
playing
2020 hindsight, now that I know he got loose for 49 yards, would I go for it? Yeah, I'd go for it now. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, but you can't no. call a game no. thinking about what happened. You got to call a game in the moment, knowing that, man, my defense has been outstanding. Look how many times they had. Because this game really, Skip, the Texans should have won this game by 20 points.
I think Dallas should have won by 7.
Skip, they got stopped. They got stopped with goal to go on 3-4 different occasions.
That's credit to the
defense.
That's
what I'm saying.
And so for me, when I look at that, and I'm Jason Garrett, it's a no-brainer that I'm putting my defense out there because my trust lies in my defense right
and
now.
And not what? Well, hello.
Not in Dak, not in
Zeke.
Whoa.
Skip Bayless tells mm-hmm. me, been telling me since 2016, that this guy here is he played the greatest rookie season at quarterback.
You disagree?
It's not your turn. I'm talking to Greg. He tells me all
separate
the time.
Combo.
He tells me all the time. Now, all of a sudden, coach can't even trust the guy to make a play, get 1 yard.
Hmm. The thing is, if they go for it and they don't get it,
we're going to kill him.
Yes, because our defense is playing too good for us to even go for it.
We're going
to
kill him, yes.
Well, guess who did kill him in the locker room after the game? The general manager and owner of the Dallas Cowboys, Jerry Jones. For the first time I can ever remember, he criticized his son, Jason Garrett, and the quote was, "We should have risked at that particular time." So the owner disagrees with us, and I'm just thinking.
And it doesn't work out. Guess what they're going to say? What a dumb call by Jason Garrett while Jerry Jones is upstairs. And I bet you he wouldn't have said that then. I bet you he wouldn't have said, I agree with Jason Garrett's decision. Now, because he didn't go for it,
and you saw
they
lose
the game. Yes, exactly.
That is probably true. Once upon a time, Jerry Jones made his fortune plunging, right? Yeah. And he used to be the ultimate plunger as the owner of the football
team. What you tell me now?
He doesn't plunge anymore.
Exactly. He lost his guts to plunge.
He is resting on his laurels in the Hall of Fame.